Everyone in this arena has a money stake in one of our famous couples as we play the game of celebrity gossip, Tattletales. And here's the star of Tattletales, Bert Convy.
I thank everybody. Welcome to Tattletales and welcome to you too. And you can all stay right where you are, and you too, because we're going to do this one more time till we get it right. If you've been with us at all the last few meetings, you know that it's been sheer madness. And today will be just exactly the same. I promise you that. On top of that, you're going to win some money. You here in the studio and you at home, come on down and see us and you'll win some money too. Here they are, winning money for the blue section. In blue, Mr. Jerry Vale and his wife, Rita Vale.
Thank you, Bert. It's been a great week.
Have you had fun?
Oh, I really enjoyed it.
And you'll come back and see us again, Rita?
Oh, we'd love it. It was really fun.
It's really
sensational.
See, it's fun to do, and it's good that you were wonderful to your rooting sections. They're lucky to have you today. Also lucky to have this next couple for the bananas, because they seem to fit. Seems right. Just only natural, doesn't it? Tony Fields and her husband, Georgie Johnston. Oh, this was
really big.
Pretty big.
For the bananas. I like the banana section.
The bananas. Right. Strong for you.
This has been the worst week I have spent in 20 years.
Oh, Tony, no. Really?
Well. He just doesn't think. I mean, if this man would only
think. Don't think? What do you mean, I don't think?
You don't think, Georgie. You really don't think.
Yeah, I'm going to call a cop.
Today is a different day.
It's a new day,
and he's going to think, and it's going to be terrific. You'll see. Winning money today for the red section, and they've been goody two-shoes for the last several days.
Oh, yeah, you
they
can't believe it.
So
sickening.
Well, Ross Martin and his wife, Olavi.
We're winning.
Well, you have done very well, it's true.
Oh, we've been very lucky, and we've been married a long time, you know.
How long have you been married, Ross?
Well, about 9 years.
Oh, are you crazy?
Did he get it wrong, Tony?
Well, what's so long about that? I'm married 25 years, and I don't know who this man is.
You guys travel. That's my point. You know, we're together all the time.
We got a lot of time. I'm married 17.
You're married 17
and
years.
And we only won one game.
Well, you're all going to try and win this one. If you're ready, Olivia, here comes the first question worth $150.
Oh, this is for us, huh?
This is for
all three.
Ladies.
Yes.
Yeah, I'm ready, but I hate for this week to end. It's been such fun.
Oh, well, I feel that way, too. Maybe it won't end. We'll just keep on going.
Okay.
If you had to make a choice, which would you say is generally more attractive to you? A man who's slightly underweight or a man who's slightly overweight? Think it over. Goodbye. I don't know the significance of this question. What do you think Rita will say? What is more attractive to Rita, a man who's slightly underweight or a man who's slightly overweight? Slightly is the key word, I believe.
Well, I'm slightly overweight.
Yes.
About maybe 8 or 10 pounds.
Mm-hmm.
I think she wants to have something to hold on to.
Mm-hmm.
I would say that Rita would say slightly overweight so that she could... If she had to thin him a little bit, you know, she could do it.
She could do it, yes? Okay. So funny. Jerry said, I'm about 8 or 9 pounds overweight. And somebody in a red section, a lady, said, well, that's not bad. No, it's not bad at all. You'll say, overweight, here she comes.
Slightly,
yes, of course. If you had to make a choice, Rita, which would you say is generally more attractive to you, a man who is slightly underweight or a man who is slightly overweight?
Well, depends on the man.
Of course, yes.
I would say a man that was slightly underweight.
No, Jerry said
overweight.
Reader, I'm overweight. How
Jerry's
could you
just
say
saying that?
That
because he's overweight. I knew that was my first instinct.
Rita said, okay, overweight.
Why didn't you say it?
Because maybe you'll lose weight.
Sorry about that. Rita, it's the way it goes. It's her way of telling you in front of America.
Right.
Get rid of those 8 pounds, Jerry.
Do you think I'm fat?
Yes.
It's about 50-50, Jerry. what will Tony say, George?
this is a difficult one. I'm in Jerry's boat, too. Same thing. I think Tony will probably say slightly overweight.
She will.
Only because of her image.
Think so? Oh, see? Now listen to what he's saying. What
only
is the
because
red
of her image.
Yelling about there?
Well, Okay.
Right. You'll say slightly
I think
overweight.
She'll probably say slightly overweight.
Here she comes. Love it. Tony, if you had to make a choice, which would you say is generally more attractive to you, a man who's slightly underweight or a man who's slightly overweight?
Well, first of all, I have maintained my weight so well throughout the years. Yes. I love little thin men. I think they're adorable because I have a mother complex, and I like little skinny men.
No, that's not what George said. Oh, is he going to get it now?
Oh, wow.
Tell him, Tony.
Georgie.
What? I said because of your image, you'd probably say slightly overweight.
Do I like fat things?
No, no.
Do I like fat people?
No, no.
Don't I love and envy
skinny
everybody
people.
In the world?
Right.
Then what the hell is your answer? I can't believe you said that, dummy.
First divorce on national TV.
Oh, no, it's a moving right along
no, the
there
second,
while Tony tries to figure out what George is talking about. Ross, you got a chance to get the whole thing for the red section here.
Yeah, but I always get it when it's only 75, right? Knowing Olivia, her philosophy is that you can't be too rich or too thin. And she would choose a guy who's slightly underweight.
Slightly
She'd find
underweight.
Him more attractive as between the two.
Yeah. How are you standing about now? Where are you?
I'm overweight.
Are you?
Yeah.
All right.
I'm overweight by more than I'd like to be.
I see. Okay. Well, let's see if Olivia's still there. We'll get her answer. Olivia, if you had to make a choice, which would you say is generally more attractive to you, a man who is underweight slightly or a man who is slightly overweight?
Here goes the end of the goody two-shoes reputation. Slightly underweight.
That's the one. You got it. You got the whole thing for the red section. That's funny. We'll come back in a moment and play question number 2, 3, and 4. Don't go away. See you in a moment. Here we go. Question number 2 coming up. That was kind of a mess. I was a little surprised.
Tricky one. Yeah, tricky
one. Interesting, huh? Okay, here we go. This one's worth $150 as well, ladies. Looking back on your life together, which of you had more reasons to say, "I told you so," you or your husband? Ooh, how many? Oh, does that come up? Think it over, ladies. Off they go. We'll start with you, Georgie. Looking back now, which of you had more reasons to say, "I told you so"? Reasons.
Who had more reason to say I told you so?
Yeah, who had more reasons to say I told you so?
Oh, that's so difficult. I would say probably Toadie had more reason to say I told you so.
Really?
Yeah, I think she'll say, I think that she probably
What would be a typical reason? What do you do?
Oh,
what do you
I
find
don't
yourself
know.
Doing? That?
Why don't you go by your first instinct on an answer, I told you so. That's like something like that.
That's right. And she has been saying that to
yes,
you.
Yes, that's what
All right,
I
so you'll
that.
Say...
That she would have more reason to say I told you so than I did.
Okay, had more reasons to say I told you so. Yes,
yeah.
Here she comes. It's tricky. It is tricky, isn't it? Looking back on your life together, Toadie, which of you had more reasons to say I told you so? You or George?
Well, it is tough because I'm very gullible. I'm a very gullible person, and Georgie's always telling me, I told you so.
No.
Oh!
That's not what he said.
Georgie, I can't believe it, honey.
Well?
You always say to me, I told you so.
No, no, he said, who had more reason?
Who had more reasons to say?
He tells you without any reason.
I told you so.
I would have said what Georgie said.
Yeah.
Because Georgie's always saying, I told you not to do that, and I told you so, and I told you there, and I told you so.
Meaning he had the reason to say that to you. Is that correct? Is that what you're saying, Tony? That
he's always wrong.
Yeah.
So,
so he's never had the reason.
Well, this time he did it again, didn't he?
No, it's not his fault.
Sorry about that,
that
Tony.
Could go either
Ross,
way.
What will Olivia say?
Give me that question again.
Well, it's worded this way. Looking back on your life together, which of you had more reasons to say, I told you so?
Olivia, without question.
Really? Because you have made mistakes and she has warned
Well, I
haven't.
She warns me about things like eating food that's excessively spicy.
Yes.
And, you know, taking the one glass of wine over beyond what I should have so that I wind up with a headache and that kind of thing. And she's been right. She's been right almost every time.
So she's had more reasons.
It's a pain in the neck, but she's been right.
Yes. I told you so. Here she comes. Olivia,
yes, dear.
Which of you had more reasons to say, I told you so?
Had more reasons. That doesn't mean that we did it, but we had the reasons.
Mm,
it's very...
They play with those words.
Well, that's important.
That's right.
And,
which of you had more reasons
close,
to say?
It's very close, but I'm going to say that I have.
That's it. That's the one. That's hard.
We kind of know one another, Bert. Yes. It must show.
But reasons has to mean that you were right ultimately, yeah. too. And you're right again. Jerry, what will Rita say?
Well, she's told me I told you so on both good and bad things. So I would have to say that she would probably say that she has said more often I told you so.
And had more reasons. That's
yes.
what we're looking for. Mm-hmm. She's the one.
Yes,
here
I
she
would
comes.
Say so.
Rita, looking back yes. on your life together with Jerry, which of you had more reasons to say, I told you so? You or Jerry?
I think that Jerry would say to me, I told you so, because he blames me for everything.
No, that's not what he said. Guess what? Ross and all of you got the whole thing again. At halftime, fellas, step to the rear. We'll bring the ladies out front. We'll come back with the second half in a moment. Don't go away. See you in a moment. Well, I tell you, it's not over, gang. No matter what you might think, it is not over. We have changed places after halftime. We have Ross and Olivia in the lead with $300 to Zip Zip. But never fear, we have $450 to give away. Still could end up any other way. If you had an affair, is there anybody you know you would trust with this secret? Yes or no? Off you go. Goodbye. It's interesting. I think it's kind of a who talks more almost kind of a question. And we'll start with you, Olivia, since you've got the lead at the moment. Is there anybody that he knows that he would trust with the secret?
Yes.
There is.
And he'll say yes.
Really? Who would it be?
You want his name? Paul Esco.
Really?
That's yes, one of his closest friends.
Really?
Yeah. Oh, and there are several.
Well, why don't we get
Dr.
Paul
Gonsi,
on the phone
a lot of
now?
Nice.
Say, Paul, yeah. this is Ross.
Yeah.
Okay, it would be, yeah, the answer is yes then.
I think that he has some friends that he could trust with that. It would never happen,
no,
but I have to answer
you. Of course not. We say that. We know this could never happen. It's printed right on my card. See? We know this could never happen. Here he comes now. Ross,
yes.
If you had an affair, we know it could never happen. Is there anybody you know you would trust with this secret?
Why were they laughing when you said we know it would never happen or know it could never
happen?
Well,
I keep saying that. I've got a nervous cough already.
There's a little whitewash going. That I would trust or
yes.
could trust?
Is there anybody that you know you would trust with this secret? Yes or no?
There's an old saying that three can keep a secret if two of them are dead. There is somebody I know that I could trust with a secret.
Yeah.
But... why would I tell anybody anything like that? No.
No, that's not what she said. She said yes. She said there was somebody. She said there was somebody, and she gave
would
us a
name.
Could
you read him that question again? Just
if you had an affair.
If.
Yes.
You had an affair.
Yes.
Is there anybody
is there
you know you would trust with
anybody.
This secret?
That
anybody.
I would
that
trust.
No.
Uh-huh. That's the key
no.
word. I say there's someone I could trust. But
that's
there's no one I would trust.
But he wouldn't do it. Okay, Rita,
that's
what's
it.
Jerry going to say? You got a chance to get on the boards here.
No, Jerry would say no.
He would say
there
no.
would be no one he could trust, and he wouldn't tell.
And he wouldn't tell anybody.
No.
Okay.
He might tell Tody, but he wouldn't tell. No, no.
And Tody wouldn't tell anybody.
He wouldn't have to tell me. I would know.
Oops.
That's oh. true. No.
We could take that no. several hundred ways, couldn't we?
Yeah.
Let's bring on Jerry now. Jerry, we know this could never happen. I keep saying. But if you had an affair, is there anybody you know you would trust with this secret? Yes or no?
Well, up to now, nobody said anything. I'm just kidding. would I have someone that I could trust with
yes.
the secret?
Is there anybody you know that you would trust with this secret?
Yes.
No. Rita said no.
Jerry, you're going with Georgie right after this show. The two of you.
I could trust Georgie.
You could trust Georgie. But would you tell him?
I can't believe it.
Would I tell him?
Never mind. It's too late now. Tony, what will Georgie say to this? Up.
No contest.
No.
We have the money.
Uh-huh.
No. Well, I want to tell you something. My husband is so close-mouthed. First of all, he's so afraid of me. He wouldn't trust anybody in this world if he had an affair. He would tell no one.
Right.
Out of respect to my knowing or here, his here. Daughter's knowing.
Aha.
So, there is not a human being alive.
So the answer is no, and we know this could never happen. We're covered on every base, aren't we? Here he comes now. Georgia, you got a chance to get the whole thing for the banana section, which makes this very interesting.
Oh, if I miss this, she'll kill me.
That's true. We know this could never happen, but if you had an affair, is there anybody you know that you would trust with the secret?
My answer would be no. I would never.
That's it. You got it. All right.
Yeah, I agree.
You got the whole thing, Georgie. We'll come back in just a moment with the $300 question. I told you it's not over. Here we go. All right, this question worth $300, and I told you it's not over because it isn't. Look what we have up here on the board. George, you got a good chance. If you get this one right, you got it.
And if I get it wrong, you got it.
No.
What if he gets it right and I get it right?
then you have it.
Yes. Right.
You both got it, but not to the same degree. Here's right. The question's worth $300. Men, your wife gives you an engraved gold fountain pen for your anniversary. You lose it. A friend tells you not to be upset because there's a place nearby where you can get another exactly like it and even have it engraved so your wife will never know the difference. Would you do that? Yes or no? It's a yes or no question. You could get another one exactly like it, have it engraved. She'd never know. It's a gold pen and it's for your anniversary. Think it over, fellas. Off you go. I think that's a tough question.
It is tough. Yeah,
boy. Because you're dealing with another person's feelings. On the other hand, what do you think, Rita?
No, Jerry would never get another one. He would just lose it and forget about it.
He would?
He would. He's done it before.
He has?
Yes.
What did he lose?
I've given him beautiful cufflinks on, you know, various occasions and so on and so forth. And he just loses them and he says, I lost them. And that's it.
And that's it?
And that's it. It's over.
Well, it's called not crying over a spilt cufflink.
No, because those things are really not important to Jerry. I mean, jewelry or what, not that what I give him isn't important.
Right.
But things of that value, it's just a thing, and he really wouldn't care. And he would, I don't think he would, he wouldn't replace it.
All right, so he wouldn't do it. The answer is no, here he comes. Okay, see, that's a good side too. Ugh. Jerry, Rita's given you a gold fountain pen engraved for your anniversary. You lose it, friend says, you can get another one exactly like it, have it engraved, she'll never know. Would you do it, yes or no?
I think that Rita would probably say it would be of sentimental value. No.
That's right. That's what she said. Wow. I thought he was going to say, I thought he was going to go the other way. Sentimental value, but he said no. Absolutely not. He wouldn't do it. Wow.
He wouldn't do it. No.
All right. That's right. Tony, what will Georgie say?
Well, my husband puts no value on material things.
Uh-huh.
If I gave him a solid gold pen, he wouldn't know it was a solid gold pen.
Anyway.
He likes a felt pen.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Sure.
I could take a pen and scratch Georgie on it. He couldn't care less. He does not give a darn about material things. He would come to me and say, I feel very bad. I lost the pen. He couldn't care less about a pen.
So he wouldn't do it. The answer is
never.
No.
Never.
No. Here he comes.
Never.
Ooh, here we go. It's getting interesting, gang. See what's going on here on the scoreboard? Here you come. George.
Yes.
You got this gold pen.
Right.
It's engraved.
Right.
Tony gives it to you for your anniversary.
Oh, isn't she lovely?
Yes. Oh, she said. But guess what happens?
What?
You lose it.
Oh.
Friend says, hey, don't be upset. Get you another one exactly like it. Same pen.
Right.
Engraved. Tony will never know. Would you do that?
Sure.
No, she said no.
Woo! Georgie.
What? Well, of course
Georgie.
I would get it. Yes.
Oh, God. Wait a minute, I want to hear this. Oh, go ahead, Tony.
Georgie, when was the last time you walked into a store for anything in this world?
Would I tell you I lost it, I would go and buy another one.
That's what the man said.
Georgie, I would say something, but we would be off the air.
I bet it had something to do with wearing that pen. Olivia, what will Ross say? Here we go. This is the game. By golly, look what can happen here.
Do I answer now?
Yes.
Oh, he's already answered. No, he
hasn't come on yet.
Would he
get that pen? Would he get the
I would possibly do what you
said.
Yes. I might do that, but I would say no, he wouldn't.
He wouldn't do it.
He would tell me.
Okay.
And then decide whether or not we should go get another one.
Okay, here he comes. I told everybody it wasn't over. It isn't. Reed and Jerry have it right. They're fighting to tie you.
Oh, my Lord.
What are you going to do? You're going to take that fountain pen, you lose it. It's a gold pen.
Wait a minute. The question is what?
Now, the question is...
I'm having an affair with a fountain pen on our golden anniversary?
Olivia gave you a gold fountain pen for your anniversary. You lose it. A friend says, don't be upset. I'll get you another one exactly like it, engraved and everything. Olivia will never know. Would you do it? Yes or no?
Then the basis of this question is not telling Olivia I've lost it, right?
I guess so, if you want to take it that way.
I would tell Olivia.
So you wouldn't do it? The answer is no. You're right. Olivia and Ross, Reed and Jerry split the pot in half. However, Olivia and Ross win it for the Reds. We'll come back in a moment and give the Red Section their money, and they deserve it, too. See you tomorrow. The Red Section with Ross and Olivia have done it. $450. We had $1,000. They will divide $1,450. You were all wonderful. Thank you. So were you. Bert Convy saying, see you next time on Tattletales.
Graham has been edited for broadcast.